All right, in this video, we're going to demonstrate how to create a linked list using a custom data class. So I have a data item I created called food item. And inside a food item has several protected items. It'll be name, calories, and cost. Now I'm going to build a list of this. Now it's very important that you have the class correctly built for this. So notice up here I have all the operators for comparison defined. And they have to be defined in this way. Operator greater than, the left-hand side has to pass the variable by parameter, the right-hand side has to be const. And you have to define less than, greater than, etc. If you don't do this, the linked list class from the book will blow up in your face. Also, you want to have a toString defined, because the toString is going to be used in that print function that's given to us by Malik's link. And so whatever's in the toString is how the output's going to look. So it can work with any class. You know, any building classes you've already built or any class you've developed, just make sure you define toString. You decide to define your constructors, setters, and getters, setter, and you define these guys. Without those, the list will break. Okay, so let's go and make this happen. You see upon including the correct object for your environment. Remember from Visual Studio, that's .h instead of a .cpp. So let's create the unordered list. And like we did in the first video, we pass in the data type we're going to use, which in our case will be food item. I'm going to call it a food list. And when I go to insert into this, again, I'll use insert. What I have to give it is I have to give it an item of food item. So a way to do it is called a constructor here. And what that's passing in, that is passing the name of the item, the calories, and the cost. Now, I kicked the calories up pretty high, so I can show you something in little bits. I have a few more of these built. I'm just going to copy and paste them in. Create as many as you want. You can also have done something like this. You can very easily insert any food item there. So you could, you know, interface with your user, create a list, create a drop-down, ask them for data, whatever you want, and just drop in your list. Like before, if I print this thing, it'll print out the order that I put them in. So eggs is 500 calories and cost a buck, bacon is 150 calories, $3, and here's my cookie. Pretty? No. But it works. Okay, so likewise, I can create an unordered list of type food item. Let's take a look at what it does, and then I'll show you why it does it. So I'm going to run this. Bacon is 150. Toast is 200, cookies is 350, eggs is 500. It sorts them in order of calories, and there's a really good reason it does that. When I take a look at my food item class, and I find the comparison operator, here they are, you see I'm comparing calories. When I defined overloading operators in the past, I said to you, you guys have to define what greater than means, what less than means. And in this case, I decided that food shall be compared by calories. So it orders them by calories. If I change calories to be cost, it'll sort them by cost. If I change calories to be the name, it'll sort them by name. I made that decision when I built my food item class so that it would sort by calories. And you see I get that output here. Okay, moral to the story. You can use these linked lists on any data type you want. Int, float, double, string, or custom class you've built. But if you build a custom class, you need to define all six of these. They have to be defined exactly like I did them there. Const food item has to be that right-hand side. Food item ampersand has to be left-hand side. And those, of course, the data types your class. And you should define a toString. If you don't define a toString, print won't work. All right. So you've seen how to create an ordered and unordered list of two different data types.